Hello back again, guys. We are here again doing a small video for to keep talking and playing about the new maps, the new levels, and just asking their opinions. We have a few friends online. We have Fire Melon, we got Dogfather, and we also have Sean Cool talking with us. We're going to be playing for a little bit and maybe doing three or four games, and we're going to be talking about what we think about the new things that came to the game. Probably talk about some strategy. On the last video, you heard a bit about strategy on Triple Threat. Triple Threat is it's that map with the three outposts, and that you can probably cap the three bases. You win in 2 seconds, and if you get all the way to the end of the game and capped two bases at least, you will win. But let's say hello to these guys, and let's get on the way of playing. Hold on a second, please. Let me activate them. Hello guys, how are you? Shiny, Sean, Dog, how are you guys? Welcome to another video.
How's it going?
Hello, Pabucho. How are you?
Oh, fine. Thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you for being here with me and sharing your thoughts and all your knowledge about the game and your opinions on what's the new things of the game. The last time we were playing Triple Threat, you explained a little bit of the strategy and your opinion. That was amazing. Thank you for sharing all that. And let's see what we have now. We got No Man's Land, but this map also, it's kind of changed, and the strategy has been changing because of the cooldowns. What do you think about that?
I think for normal operation, everything is changing a bit, but the concept is still there, still the same. You know, you cap a base, defend a base, attack their base. But for super operation, it's different.
Okay.
That's my opinion.
Good. What do you think, Sean? Ready up, dog.
What?
We didn't hear you, Sean. What do you think about the cooldown times that we got on now on the game?
I think it's pretty fair, but I think Famer should be rare, not epic.
Say that again, what troops?
Famer should be rare, not epic, because I feel like Famer is decent without the group timer, but with the 1 minute 30 timer, it's just really bad now.
Oh, okay, Famer. And what do you think, Dog, about the cooldown times?
I like them. I think Sean's right. I think Flamer shouldn't be epic.
Okay.
The 1 minute 45 seconds, to me, it just seems like it's a very large proportion of the total battle time your troops cool down for.
Okay. Now, I
like it overall.
Okay, we were talking a little bit before we started recording this. We were talking about the way that we see things coming from SA, and that lately we have seen the guys from SA play even more consistently. I've been seeing these guys play even very, very early in the morning for me. And you guys were saying that you also have been seeing a lot of them. My opinion is that these guys are taking care of the game.
I need you to come be right now, Babucho.
Oh, wait. I'm at A. Hold on. Let me jump back to A. I'm on heavy, so I'm going to take a little while to get there. Okay, see you, we're going to A, going to B. See. Okay. Shit, I got kills. Coming back to B. Getting the Grunt army. Grunt army, in my opinion, it's still one of the best power-ups that we have. One of the greatest power-ups we have. Building defenses has come more important every now that you get damage points from all the defenses that you build and the damage that they do. Get behind those medics. Get behind those medics, Zog.
They're not healing me. They're healing you.
I need one person and pick a Zuka to go attack with me.
Okay, hold on.
Coming.
Okay, dog died. Go with Zuka now. I died and I'm gonna go back to B. Check this. Oh my god. Getting cream down here.
This level 11 Zuka just shreds the base.
That was a nice move for everybody because most of us, we got bumped up to 11 with our Zukas. That was a good move.
Got bumped up to a level 11 mega critter.
Okay, we'll stop as much as possible.
And kill these people before they get in the air. Kill them.
There you go. So I was saying, what do you think about these guys from SA, from the studio and from developers playing even more? I've been seeing more and more of these guys. It in my opinion, it's good. It looks like they're interested in testing everything out and looking at things, how they're going.
To me, it seems like they're testing more than normal, because normally you see them one in a battle by themselves, but I've seen three of them in a game together all different times.
Oh, nice. So full squads of SA guys.
Yeah, so I wonder if they're trying to test out the gameplay mechanics for squads in the new modes and whatnot. Who knows?
Okay, nice. Okay, we're gonna get Bunker Buster, Gatling Truck. Oh, and I got my cluster to 11 also. That was a big step for me, man. And my God, it works nice. I think it's one of the best troops that we have already on the game. Can do a lot of damage on the new maps.
I think Cluster does way more damage than people think to Heavy and Flamer.
Yeah. And now with all those maps with walls, they have become more relevant. Because Fire Bomber and Cluster can shoot over walls, so they're really coming into the game now. Let's see. Okay. Okay, they're gonna take down A.
Brought a bunch of those stupid bomblets.
Oh, level 3? Oh, oops.
You got level 3 Gatling truck, Shiny? You're not used to that?
Does that do like 5 damage per bullet?
I forgot, like, you know, those level boosts. It's not there anymore.
Yeah.
Okay, we need to be able to defend all those.
I only have 400 munitions, so I need to wait for a second.
See a lot of fire bombers now.
Yeah, everybody's playing fire bomber. They see the value now. They were not playing fire bombing in a long time.
We play fire bomber just for the quests.
Oh yeah. And that quest with fire bomber is crazy. It's very difficult to get it.
I mean, I can do it.
Oh my god.
What happened to our base?
Everybody's attacking our base.
Like, do we have any defense? Or?
No, we don't have any defense. I'm trying to get
all the defense.
Yeah. The only defense we have is, the rocket launcher.
Stupid fire bomber guy keeps launching stuff at everything from the spawn and he can't shoot him. And he just takes everything out from spawn.
And goes back very fast, he runs away. I know the feeling, man.
Well, they can eat some of my fire bomber doing the same thing.
Just build a big defense, like, so we can stop them.
I'm trying. There they go again. We got 3 Sukas hitting. Three Sukas, 1 jetpack, cluster. Everybody's hitting it. Fire bomber. My god, I can't defend against so many.
I think we're at an everybody to B situation. We can build. I don't know if they're going to be able to build it.
Try to cap B, guys. I'm trying to stop boss A as much as possible.
He's built. I'm trying to come help you pause it too.
Oh, they're defending so well. This will work. Can you do something, some more damage?
Need someone to go back defend. If you who died, just go back to defend.
Try to cover me if you can.
Where are you?
In the corner over here, shooting with Zuka.
Oh, nice. Nice.
I'm down in the corner, dodging the freaking mortar.
Nice. And I was just trying to do my rounds again around the outpost, trying to get everything. To focus.
I ran up on the base, and there was nobody there to support me, and I ran back to spawn, and I saw you jump in the Gatling truck, so I'm like, okay, I'm gonna go. I dropped the booster pack for you so that you'd get a little bit of a boost when you got to the bridge.
Yeah.
And I ran around the back, around the bottom, took out the missile tank, and just started running in circles.
Yeah, that was a good move.
You know, 11 Zuka is nice, man.
One thing about this, and I don't know if you guys agree, we're looking at a lot of people, as we were saying, due to the missions. Everybody's trying to do the missions as fast as possible. One of the missions that we see is the one that it's damage with warriors or damage with fire bombers, and everybody's trying to play fire bomber as much as they can, just due to that only that that mission. And the tying up the missions with all the maps, it's amazing. Makes for everybody to start spamming and using more and more the troops. So it's nice. This part of the game, it's also been, in my opinion, very well rounded up.
It's just me, or have you guys seen like double the amount of players online at all times in like the last 2 days?
Oh, I don't know what you guys say, but in my opinion, it went up exponentially. I always have 10, 20 people on my friend list playing at the same time.
At 26 right now.
That's a good number. I have 12, so. But I haven't been doing refining my list. I took a lot of guys out. So
just keep everybody in there so I can see who's online. Are we going 4x4?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take Zuka.
I will buy 4x4. Let me buy. Ooh, baby.
Up.
Level 11, boys.
There we go.
You level 11 Zuka too?
Yeah.
On this, yes.
Y'all are, oh man.
And with the premier driver, the best driver in the game, my god.
If we both shoot the HQ, it does as much damage as like one shot from a freaking
bunker buster
tank. Yeah. It's like almost 1400 damage per shot, isn't it?
Yeah. Nice game. Well done driving, Shiny.
He survived the whole game.
Well done, man. Well done. That's a nice game, bro. Well done, Shiny. And there you guys. There you go, guys. That's a lesson on how to drive and how to do damage with two Zukas. Level 11 and a good driver. You can cap both zones with just one good driver. Very nice, Shiny. I'm gonna short this video right there, ending it on that good win, man. It all goes to you, man. All the credit goes to you, bro.
Nice driving.
Very nice. Thank you for being here, guys. And I'll talk to you later. Thank you.
Yep.